The gerbils remind you to stay clean during quarantine. Good hello everyone, my name is Shine, and welcome back to another video. I know that this time is a bit crazy for everyone, and most of us are stuck at home and trying to make ways a bit easier around it. So for this video, I wanted to show you guys how you can grow flax for your pets at home. Now this is great for gerbils, hamsters, rats, and most rodents. Just make sure that your pet can have this before giving it to them by doing your research. Now the first thing we're going to look at is obviously the seeds. A good rodent diet should usually have flax seeds incorporated in them, and they can be used to grow the plant themselves. Now the seedling starts off very small and the flax seed might still be attached to it, but after that it will turn into a little sprout and eventually this whole plant will flower. This light blue, almost white fading flower is where the seed pod will form and produce the seeds. The flower is a self-pollinating flower, and this basically means that it will reproduce the seeds by itself without the needs of other insects such as bees pollinating the flower. This is great if you want to grow the flax plant indoors, because then you don't have to worry about it needing other insects to form the seed pods. Now if you look closely, you will notice these tiny stems with purple circles at the end of them, and this is the anthers of the plant, and this will fertilize the seed pod or the ovary. And the flower will slowly close in, the petals will die, and it will form the seed pod. The seed pod will start off green, and this is how you will know that it is not yet ripe or ready for harvesting. The progress will usually be fast, and the brown result is when the seeds are ready. Now that we've gone over the plant's aspects, let's go over the requirements you will need to grow the plant. I have been using a 9-inch tall container, but you can also grow it in an 8-inch, but I'd recommend an 8-inch because the roots do expand and grow tall. So the diameter of this pot is 8 inches. Now the diameter isn't as important, it can be pretty cylinder of a pot. And the plant itself grows very crazy. This plant spreads and these seed pods form in different directions. It really has no set standard. It's just pretty crazy. So you might want to consider that when placing it in a space. Now this plant will also require a lot of sun. I have placed it in front of a south-facing window, so it receives at least 6 hours of sun a day. Flax is an annual, and this basically means when the plant is done producing the seed pods, it will start to dry up completely. And it is completely normal for the leaves to look dry and falling off during the time of it producing seed pods, because it does take a lot of energy from the plant. Eventually, the whole plant will be done with its cycle, and you will have to take it all out, put it to dry, and give it to your pets as well. Flax does not like to be standing in soaked, wet soil, but you do want to give it a water when the soil is 1 inch at the top is completely dry. Give it a good soak and wait until it is again dry to water it again. You can also water this plant with tea, compost, and this basically is a bunch of components of dried organic waste in water, and this will give it a good nutrient boost, but just make sure to do this every once in a while. It definitely is not necessary, but it could help to make bigger seed pods for the plant. A good form will contain at least 8 to 10 seeds inside. And for the soil and fertilizer, I've used rabbit poop. Of course, they can't use or eat the seeds, but the plant itself is edible for rabbits as well. You can also use crushed eggshells and compost to fertilize the soil. So when you open the seed pods, of course, you will have your flax seeds. Now, I have to be honest, these are not from the seed pods that I grew. Those were store-bought flax seeds. And that's just because I like to keep them in the seed pods so that the gerbils or whatever pet you have that can have the flax can forage, and it adds stimulation. It's more of a natural habit to have to get these seeds out of the seed pods, so I really recommend giving it to them like that. But not only is this a great project to do to add stimulation and foraging habits to your rodents, but it also helps in time of a quarantine situation. You should be staying home, and I hope you are. And even if you don't need flax as readily available as this, it's still a fast-growing and efficient boredom breaker. In about 2 months, you should have a ready-to-harvest flax plant. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and make sure to give it a like and comment down below if you do try this out. Maybe show me pictures on Twitter, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!